Hi everyone, welcome to lecture 54 in EDC course. In this lecture, we will discuss about the transistor configurations. That is, we know that transistor is having three terminals, emitter, base and collector. So whenever we are operating this transistor, we need to consider one terminal as a reference terminal or common terminal, or we can say grounded terminal, right? So based on that, we'll have three configurations of a transistor. The first one is common base configuration. That means in this configuration, base terminal will be common to emitter and collector. Next, we'll have common emitter configuration. That means emitter terminal will be common to base and collector. Then finally, we'll have common collector configuration. So in this configuration, the collector terminal will be common to base and emitter, right? So whenever we are operating this transistor as an amplifier, so we need to operate in one of this configuration. So it may be common base amplifier, common emitter amplifier, common collector amplifier, and each amplifier will have its own application. So that we'll see anyway in analog circuits. Now before we discuss about these configurations, first I will give a table, that is typical NPN transistor junction voltages at 25 degree centigrade, or we can say room temperature. So what are the different modes of operation? Active mode, saturation mode and cutoff mode. For reverse active mode, we can use this active mode voltages. So we can have silicon NPN transistor, germanium NPN transistor. If it is a silicon NPN transistor, so for active region, we need to apply VBE as 0.7 volt, and if the transistor is in saturation region, VBE sat 0.8 volts and VCE sat 0.2 volts. If it is in cutoff region, so very simple, so 0 volts. But whenever the NPN transistor is made up of germanium, then VBE active is 0.2 volts. So why I am giving this table is, so in the exam, they may ask, so the transistor is in active region, right? And to find some current. So in the active region means if it is a silicon, so we need to consider directly 0.7 volt. So that's why I am giving this table. So germanium NPN transistor, VBE active means 0.2 volts. VBE sat means 0.3 volts. And VCE sat is 0.1 volt. Right? So for silicon it is 0.2, for germanium it is 0.1. In some textbooks they may follow, this is as 0.3 volts, this is 0.4 volts and this is 0.1 volt only. So VCE sat for silicon 0.2, germanium 0.1, and for cutoff we need to apply some negative value also, so minus 0.1 volt. Sometimes we can take it as 0 volts also, right? So anyway, and the transistor cutoff, the all currents will be zero, right? So no need to worry about the cutoff region. So we need to remember for active region and saturation region. Now the PNP transistor, we may have the same values, but we have to take negative values. So that is something like this. If you take negative, so VBE active will be minus 0.7 volt. Otherwise, we can take VEB, that is 0.7 volt. This is for PNP. So all voltages will be negative. If you take as it is like this, VBE, VBE sat, VCE sat and so on. If we take like this VEB, it will be positive. Similarly, VEC, suppose sat, so it will be, if it is a silicon PNP transistor, 0.2 volts. So this is for active. So for saturation, VEB sat will be 0.8 volts, right? If they give, consider VBE active as 0.6 volts, so we need to consider that voltage only. If they did not mention, we can take 0.7 volts or 0.6 volts also sometimes, right? If it is a PNP, if it is in saturation region, we have to consider VEC sat 0.2 volts and VEB sat 0.8 volts. So try to remember these values, right? Next. So before we discuss this configurations, I will give a blind rule how to identify which type of configuration. So we'll have common base CB, CE and CC configuration. So I will take NPN transistor. You can try for PNP transistor. So common base. So base terminal, base is common to emitter and collector, or we can say base is common to input and output terminals. So for input and output, base terminal will be common or reference or grounded, right? So sometimes we may get confused what is the meaning of reference. So first we will see how to identify. So if I take NPN transistor, right, so base terminal will be connected to generally grounded. If it is a NPN, so NPN, so this will be, actually we need to consider VBE, so minus plus to make forward bias, so plus minus VBE. So here generally we will apply input to the emitter. So input we will apply to the emitter in common base, and output we will take at the collector. So this is the collector, base, emitter. So output we will take at the collector. So if it is in active mode, this collector base junction should be reverse bias. So we need to apply plus to negative side, minus to this P side. And remember, this is grounded. So later we will see in the circuits, we will have the resistances and so on. But to identify, we need to see where we are applying the input and where we are taking the output. Simple. So in common base, we will apply input to the emitter. Output will take at the collector, and the remaining terminal, base terminal, will be common. Now, I hope it is clear. So similarly, when I go to common emitter, so emitter will be common. So generally it will be connected to ground. So then we can take something like this. Now this is the base. Now we will apply input to the base, and this is the collector. So I will take output at the collector side. Now see, emitter is common to input and output, then we can say it is a common emitter configuration. Later it will be used as a amplifier. So common emitter amplifier, similarly common collector. So common collector means collector will be connected to ground. So we will apply input to the base. This is, we are applying the input to the base, and we will take output at the emitter. So this is, we are taking output. So the collector terminal is common to input and output. So we can say common collector configuration. So this is how to identify. If you are having any doubt, please post a comment. Next, I will give a circuit. Try to identify which type of configuration. So this is emitter. Emitter is connected to some 2 volts, and I am giving input to base, and I am taking output at collector. So which type of configuration? See, I am applying input to the base, I am taking output at the collector. So other terminal will be common, right? Or we can say reference. Now you may ask doubt. So reference means it should be connected to actually ground. It is not always like this. See, reference means the terminal voltage should not change. See, emitter is fixed to 2 volts. So it may be fixed to 0 volts also. If that is changing, so we cannot say that is a reference terminal. So that reference terminal voltage should be fixed. So here emitter voltage is fixed at 2 volts. So still it is common emitter configuration. So try to remember like this. So where I am applying the input, where I am taking output, the other terminal will be common. So it may be fixed to 2 volts, minus 1 volts, minus 10 volts, whatever, that voltage should not change. But here input means this voltage may change, this voltage may change, but the emitter voltage will be fixed at 2 volts, 0 volts, minus 1 volts. So that means it's a common emitter. So similarly, suppose the collector is fixed at 10 volts. So here some resistance is there, and this is the base. So here I am applying some input. So here some resistance is there, Re, and if I take some output here, now which type of configuration? See, this is the base, so I'm applying input to the base, and this is the emitter, I'm taking output at emitter. So this is output. What is the other terminal? Collector, which is common, or we can say reference, because this collector voltage is fixed at 10 volts. So it is a common collector configuration, right? So even though it is a PNP transistor, something like this. So this is emitter, base, collector, right? Sometimes base is connected to, suppose, -2 volts sometime, and this collector is connected to some resistance and it is grounded. So if I take output at collector, so plus minus V naught, and if I am giving some input here, now what is the type of configuration? So I am giving input to the emitter, I am taking output at the collector, and the other terminal is common, which is fixed to -2 volts, right? If this voltage changes, then we cannot say it is a common base. So it is a common base configuration of a PNP transistor. So this is PNP. So try to identify like this. So see where we are applying the input and where we are taking the output, and automatically other terminal is common. Right? It may be fixed, it may be grounded, it may be fixed to some voltage. Positive voltage, negative voltage, doesn't matter. So that voltage should be fixed. Then we can say it is a reference. So generally, reference means generally we consider as this ground. That means this ground means it's a 0 volt. It will not change. That's why we are saying this is a reference. So I hope it is clear. Now we'll see common base configuration. Now we'll see the common base configuration. So I will consider NPN transistor. Right? So common base. So base is common. So how to draw the circuit? So see carefully. So this is the base, which will be connected to simply ground, and this is emitter, and this is collector, right? So whenever we are not applying, so we can consider this base is connected to grounded, or we can say base is common between emitter and collector. Now, so how to operate this transistor? So generally, transistor action is possible in active mode. So how to make NPN transistor in active mode? Very simple. So this is NPN. So P-type base, emitter base junction should be forward bias. So base voltage should be more compared to emitter. So base should be connected to positive side and emitter should be connected to negative side of the battery. And what is the polarities? Plus, minus, and we can denote it as VBE. And when we use in circuits, we will denote it thus, that VBE here, if there is some resistances, etc. Right? Next, collector base junction should be reverse bias. So reverse bias means we have to apply positive to N side, negative to P side. So it will become reverse bias. What is this voltage? Plus minus VCP. So VCB positive, VBE positive. Now, whenever it is in active mode, there will be currents. So emitter current is leaving. So this is the emitter current. That means the collector current should enter. This is IC. Base current also should enter, because we know the emitter current is summation of base current and collector current. And from the operation of a transistor, we know the collector current is equal to alpha times IE plus ICO, that is reverse saturation current. But in common base configuration, we will denote this ICO as ICBO. So what is this ICBO name? Is reverse saturation current in common base configuration when emitter is open. So ICBO means reverse saturation current in common base configuration when the emitter is open. So what is the meaning of emitter is open? So if I take NPN, so emitter, this is the emitter base collector. So emitter is open means, so here we'll get there is no current will flow. So IE is 0. So IE is 0. Emitter is open. So and we know collector base junction is reverse bias. So plus minus. So whenever PN junction is reverse bias, only reverse saturation current will flow. So that is this ICBO. So how it is flowing? Very simple. There is a depletion region. Due to this, a high electric field will be generated. Then the minority carriers in the P-type electrons will diffuse like this. Minority carriers, holes in the N-type will diffuse like this. Now what is the current direction? It is like this, which is ICBO. So holes are moving like this. So the current direction will be the hole movement. So this is electron movement, opposite of electron movement. So this is the ICBO. Right? Next we need to find what is alpha. So that is already we know, but anyway we will see one more time. So IC is equal to alpha times IE plus ICBO. So remember this equation. So sometimes in the gate exam they may give ICBO, some IC, so we need to find alpha or sometimes IE and so on. And we know ICBO is very small. So it is very small, so that we can neglect this one. So IC will be approximately alpha times IE. So what is alpha? It is IC by IE. So what is this? It is the current gain in common base configuration. Why I am telling you is, if I see this circuit, so in common base we are applying input to the emitter and we will take output at the collector. So what is the output current IC? What is the input current IE? So gain means output by input. So here we are talking about the current. So current gain is output current by input current. So what is the output current IC and what is the input current IE? So that's why it is current gain in common base. Now sometimes we may have the name like this, DC current gain. DC current gain. So what is the DC means? When we apply DC voltage, so we are applying the DC voltages, so this alpha can be called as DC current gain in common base, which is IC by IE. Sometimes we can say static current gain also, right? It is also same, DC current gain, static current gain, or simply current gain in common base configuration, it is alpha. Similarly, we can draw for PNP transistor also. Only the current directions will change. So PNP, so the current direction is into the emitter. So emitter, base, collector. So again, base terminal is grounded. Active region, so PN, so P type should be connected to positive side of the battery, N type negative side. So plus minus, now see VEB, and here reverse bias, minus plus, so plus minus VBC, or we can say VCB negative. So this is common base configuration of a PNP transistor. Again here also, this is input side, this will be output side. So what is the input current? IE. That means output current will be IC, and this current also will leave. Why? Because the emitter current is summation of base and collector. Same, IC is equal to alpha times IE plus ICBO. Same equations, only the current directions will change. Right, so this is about the common base configuration. So here we need to remember one term, that is ICBO. So reverse saturation current in common base configuration when the emitter is open. Next we'll discuss the common emitter configuration. So in this configuration, the emitter terminal will be common to base and collector terminal. So again, I will take NPN transistor. You can try for PNP transistor. So if I take NPN transistor, something like this. So this is the collector terminal, this is the base, and this is the emitter. So emitter should be connected to ground terminal or reference terminal to make common. Then how to make this transistor in active mode? So emitter by junction forward bias, collector by junction reverse bias. So for that I have to apply. So this is NPN. So P side, positive side, this N side and negative side of the battery. That is something like this. So what are the polarities? It will be plus minus VBE. Next, how to make collector by junction reverse bias? Now for that, see, the collector is N-type. So N-type should be connected to positive side of the battery. So here I am giving some different supply voltage. So here I am giving some VCC. This is called supply voltage. So plus is connected to N-type semiconductor. But still, how can we say the collector by junction is reverse bias? So for that I will go like this. Always remember, whenever we consider VBE, it is the potential difference between base and emitter. So that we can write as VB minus VE. And if I see emitter is connected to ground, that means VE is a simply a 0 volt. So we can replace VE as 0. So what is VBE? It is VBE. Or VBE is VBE. If it is an active region, so we can take it as 0.7 volt. Now, and what is VC? So VC is VCC, which is supply voltage. Now, how to make collector by junction reverse bias? The collector voltage, which is VC, and this is VB. So VC voltage should be greater than VB voltage. If that condition satisfies, that is VC is greater than VB, then we can say collector by junction is in a reverse bias. What is VC? It is VCC. So VCC is greater than VB is 0.7 volt, right? So VCC will be more than 0.7 volt. So generally we will apply VCC, the supply voltage, like 5 volts, 10 volts, 15 volts and so on. Right, so this condition always satisfies if VB is very small compared to VCC. That means the collector base junction will be reverse bias. That means this is, we are applying VCB. So VC is greater than VB. So collector base junction is reverse bias. Right, similarly, we can find VCE, like VC minus VE, right, VBC. So VB minus VC, so whatever, VEB, like VE minus VB and so on, right? So in numericals, we will do like this. Next, we need to see the currents. So it is NPN transistor. The emitter current will leave the emitter terminal, that is IE. Base current will enter into the base. Collector current is also enter into the collector. But where we have to apply the input and where we will take the output. So in a common emitter, I will apply input to the base side and will take output at collector. So that means output is collector current, input is base current, right? So based on that, we will find the gains, etc. So we know IE is equal to IB plus IC. Equation 1. We know IC is equal to alpha times IE plus ICBO from the common base configuration. Right? But I need current gain in common emitter. So how to find that? So we know, what is this IE? What is IE? IB plus IC. So we can replace IC. I mean, you can replace IE by this term, that is IB plus IC plus ICBO. So, see, IC alpha IC. So IC, if I take common, it is 1 minus alpha. is equal to alpha times IB plus ICBO. And if I take this term that side, so it is alpha by 1 minus alpha into IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha into ICBO. So what is this term? So this term we are denoting as some beta, right? So beta is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha. So IC is equal to beta times IB. If this beta is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha, what is 1 minus alpha or 1 by 1 minus alpha, we'll see, right? So beta 1 minus alpha is equal to alpha. So beta minus beta alpha is equal to alpha. Beta is equal to, if I take alpha common, it will be 1 plus beta. So what is alpha? Beta by beta plus 1, right? So this is the relation between alpha and beta. If alpha is given, we can find beta. If beta is given, we can find alpha. Now from this, we know that alpha is 0.95 to 0.99, right? So then using this relation, beta will be like 50 to 250. Beta range is 50 to 250, alpha range is 0.95 to 0.99. so generally approximately we can take 1 also sometimes. Next, what is 1 minus alpha? We'll see. So 1 minus alpha we can write as 1 minus beta by beta plus 1. So beta plus 1 minus beta by beta plus 1. So what is 1 minus alpha? It is 1 by beta plus 1. So here we can replace this 1 minus alpha by 1 by beta plus 1. So this will come out as beta plus 1 times of ICBO. So this is the collector current in common emitter configuration, right? And we will denote this beta plus 1 into ICBO by ICEO. So ICEO is beta plus 1 times ICBO. What is ICBO? Reverse saturation current in common base configuration when the emitter is open. Now we have to define this term ICEO. Reverse saturation current in common emitter configuration when base is open. So here emitter will be open, here base will be open. How? That also will see. So I hope these relations are clear. Beta is alpha by 1 minus alpha. So how we are getting 50 to 250? Suppose if alpha is 0.95, so beta will be 0.95 by 1 minus 0.95. So 0.95 by 0.05, so it will be 95 by 5, right? So this is a beta. So it will be like a 19 or 20, and so on, right? So depending on this alpha value, we will get ranges in 50 to 250. Actually it is small compared to this. So generally the beta range is 50 to 250, so very large value compared to alpha, right? So we'll further proceed. So in common emitter configuration, we'll have two current equations. IE is IB plus IC, and IC is beta times IB plus ICEO. But what is ICEO? It is beta plus 1 times of ICBO. Sometimes we may get questions based on this reverse saturation currents also. So try to remember this. And we know, so ICBO approximate, I mean it is very small because it's a reverse saturation current. So we can neglect ICEO and we can write IC is approximately beta times IB. So beta is IC by IB. So again, what is the output? So collector current. What is the input? Base current. So it is again, say current gain in common emitter configuration, right? So beta is called current gain in common emitter configuration. So this is also called DC current gain in common emitter configuration. So beta, So sometimes you may see beta DC, right, alpha DC and so on. So DC current gains. So in common emitter, output is collector, input is base, emitter is common. So this is the current gain. So if you are having any doubt, please post a comment. So finally we will see common collector configurations. So for PNP transistor, try to analyze on your own. We will get the same expressions, only the current directions will change. So we'll see last one, common collector configuration. But before that, I will explain what is this reverse saturation current in CE configuration when base is open, right? So for that, I will consider NPN transistor, something like this. So this is the base, it will be open. This is the collector and this is the emitter. And we know in a active mode, emitter base junction is forward bias. So forward bias means base is connected to positive side, N is connected to negative side. That means it is connected to negative side. And collector base junction is reverse bias. That means N should be connected to positive side. So this is the voltage, that is plus minus V C E. Right? So that's why in a CE configuration, saturation mode, we see sat we are getting, right? So when this is the reverse bias, so same thing will happen, right? So the minority carriers, will diffuse. So this will be the ICEO. That will be come out as ICEO. So this is how this ICEO is flowing when the base is open. Now we'll see common collector configuration. So again, NPN transistor. So this is common. So that is common means we can apply a fixed voltage, some VCC. So collector, base, emitter. So same VBE. Positive, right? Plus minus points on volt. So NPN. So plus minus VPE. This is, so we can go for zero or grounded or plus VCC. Why? Because I need to make collector base junction a reverse bias. So I have to apply VCB here. So this VC is VCC, which is greater than VBE. You know, it is in common collector configuration. See, emitter is not connected to ground. So in this case, IB is flowing like this, IE is flowing like this, IC is flowing like this, because it is a NPN transistor. So where I should apply the input base. So this is, we have to apply input and we can take output from the emitter. So later we'll see how to take the output using some resistances. So here I'll take the output. So input is base, output is at emitter, right? So same equations, current equations we need to consider. So IE is equal to IB plus IC, equation 1, right? Next, now we know IC is equal to alpha times IE plus ICBO. This is equation 2. Now here we have to replace IC here, because IC is common, output is emitter, input is base. So what is IC from the equation 1? IC is equal to IE minus IB. So IE minus IB is equal to alpha times IE plus ICBO, right? So if I take IE common, it will be 1 minus alpha is equal to IB is going that side, so IB plus ICBO. So what is IE? It is 1 by 1 minus alpha IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha ICBO. And we have found what is 1 minus alpha. It is 1 by 1 plus beta. Yes or no? If you are having confusion, we will go like this. 1 minus alpha means beta by beta plus 1. So it will be beta plus 1 minus beta, so it will be 1 by 1 plus beta or beta plus 1. So if I replace 1 by 1 minus alpha by beta plus 1, right? So IE will be beta plus 1 times of IP plus beta plus 1 times of ICBO. So beta plus 1 times of ICBO, that we know already, ICEO, right? So this is the emitter current in common collector configuration. So here we will denote this beta plus 1 by some other parameter which is called gamma. So this is the current gain in common collector configuration. So gamma. And we know IC is, we can neglect approximately compared to this beta plus 1 times of IB. So IE is approximately beta plus 1 times of IB, or IE is equal to gamma times IB. So what is gamma? IE by IB. See, this is the output current, this is the input current. So this is the current gain in common collector configuration. So in which configuration the current gain is large? We know alpha is approximately 1 in common base, beta is 50 to 250 which is in common emitter, and gamma which is beta plus 1. So approximately we can say beta also 51 to 251, it is in common collector. So in these two configurations the current gain is large. So here it is 1, right? So based on this we'll have different applications that we will see when we discuss the amplifiers. So what we need to remember, relation between alpha, beta, gamma. So alpha is equal to beta by beta plus 1, beta is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha, gamma is beta plus 1. So here we can relate gamma and alpha also. First we need to remember these three, then we can find whatever we want. So gamma is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha plus 1, so it will be alpha plus 1 minus alpha, so it will be 1 by 1 minus alpha. So gamma is 1 by 1 minus alpha. And we should know alpha means IC by IE, common base configuration. Beta is IC by IB, common emitter configuration. And finally gamma, IE by IB, common collector configuration. So I hope it is clear. If you are hanging around, please post a comment.